Welcome back to Derivatives and Risk Education. Today, we're diving into a fundamental concept in finance, continuous compounding. This is crucial for understanding many aspects of finance, including forward prices, which we'll cover in the next lesson, and also option pricing, which we'll look at later in the course. Let's start by reminding ourselves how compound interest works. To make this easier, let's use a specific example. An initial investment of $100 and an annual interest rate of 10%. If we invest $100 for 1 year at 10% interest paid annually, the accumulated amount A is 100 times 1 plus 10%, so 100 times 1.1, which equals $110. If we invest for 2 years, we also get interest on the interest earned in the first year. This is the compounding effect. So A now equals 100 times 1.1 from the first year, and then another times 1.1, so we get 121, and so on. So for 3 years, we get 100 times 1.1 to the power of 3. We can see a pattern here. For 2 years, the accumulated amount is 100 times 1.1 to the power of t. Now, what if the interest is compounded twice a year, every 6 months? We start again with $100 and a rate of 10%, then the formula becomes 100 times 1 plus 10% divided by 2, and then to the power of 2 times t. So here, we divide the annual rate of 10% by 2, because every 6 months we just get half the 10%, and we multiply the number of years by 2, as we get interest paid twice per year, and so on. The interest is compounded quarterly, 4 times a year, and we divide the annual rate by 4 and multiply the number of years by 4. Let's now generalize all of this. If we start with a principal amount P instead of our $100 and receive R percent interest for T years compounded M times per year, then the accumulated amount A is P times 1 plus R over M to the power of MT. So we multiply our starting amount P by 1 plus the interest rate r divided by m, which is how many times we receive the interest per year, and that expression to the power of m times t, which is the number of periods per year m times the number of years t. So mt is the total number of periods. Now, we are interested in continuous compounding. This is when our compounding frequency m approaches infinity. Mathematically, we can write the continuous compounding case like this. The expression is the same, but we will take the limit of m as it approaches infinity. To proceed, we make a substitution that a new variable n equal m divided by r. Then m is equal to n times r. Substituting this into our equation, we get a equals p times 1 plus 1 over n to the power of nrt. Now, as we keep increasing the compounding frequency and m approaches infinity, then n also approaches infinity, because n is just m divided by the constant r. Then, reorganizing the powers, using the fact that x to the power of yz is equal to x to the power of y all to the power of z, we get the following expression. We can also move the limit to be only around the part with n, because p, r, and t are just constants. So we get this expression. Now, the key next step relies on the fact that the limit of 1 plus 1 over n to the power of n as n approaches infinity is one of the definitions of the constant e, which is Euler's number. Therefore, we can replace 1 plus 1 over n to the power of n as n approaches infinity with just e, and we get our formula. P times e to the power of rt is the type of compounding expression which we will use all the time in future lessons. It includes the number e, which is a fundamental mathematical constant, like pi, and appears in many areas of mathematics and science, including finance. Don't worry if you could not totally follow the maths. The key part is that you're familiar with this type of expression, with e to the power of rt, and know that it represents some rate r compounded continuously. Continuous compounding is used in many financial calculations, calculating present and future values, and in derivatives pricing. We will use this concept in our next lesson, where we will calculate forward prices. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like and subscribe.